Hey there, it's Kaylee. Welcome to Finding Equivalent Fractions. Equivalent fractions have the same value, even if they look different. These fractions here have the same value because when you multiply the top and the bottom by the same number, it is the same as multiplying by 1. And the fraction keeps its value. The same idea occurs to these over here. But instead of multiplying, we are dividing the top and the bottom by the same number. So the fractions have the same value. Let's do some on our own. So this first one here, we're finding the equivalent fraction to 3/5, or 3/5. We need to know what that equals. So remember, we either multiply or divide the top and the bottom by the same number. So looking at our possible answers here, this one here has a 10 in the numerator, but there's nothing that we can multiply this 3 by to get 10, so we know that that can't be an answer. And this one has a 3 in the numerator, but if we multiplied the numerator by 1, then we'd also have to multiply our denominator by 1, and that would give us 3/5, not 3/8. So we know that one can't be it. Then these ones both have 9s, in the numerator. So if we have 3/5 and I need to get a 9 up here, that means I had to multiply my numerator by 3. So if it's equivalent, I have to also multiply my denominator by 3. 5 times 3 gives me 15. So there's our answer right there. Let's do another one together. So this one says 5/15, or 5/15. So remember, we can multiply or divide our top and our bottom by the same number to see what we get. All right, so let's say I'm going to divide my top and my bottom both by 5. So 5 divided by 5, that would give me 1, and 5 goes into 15 3 times. So I know I have one equivalent fraction, that would be 1/3. But none of these answers here look like 1/3. Does it look like one of these could be equivalent to 1/3? So let's say, what if I multiplied my top and my bottom both by 2? 1 times 2 would be 2, and 2 times 3 would be 6. But none of those look like 2/6 either. So what if I go back to my 1/3 and I multiply my top and my bottom by 3? That would give me 3 on top and 9 on the bottom, which does look like that one there. So see, this one was a little trickier. We had to find essentially two equivalent fractions to have one of our answers show up here. Nice work. Let's do one more. So this one here, we have 2/4. And can you think of, right off the top of your head, an equivalent fraction to 2/4? Yeah, 1/2. So I got that by dividing both of these by 2. Now, if I know an equivalent fraction to 2/4 is 1/2, does it look like in any of these answers here that one of these is also equal to 1/2? Yeah, this one's a little easier. 5/10. So 5/10, if we divide both of these, by 5, I'll get 1/2. Nice work. So go ahead and practice what you've learned about finding equivalent fractions on your own by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.